Hi everybody, welcome back. My name is Brandon. I'm here in the lab at Isolate Extraction Systems, ready to bring you guys another science-filled episode of Will It Extract? Now in our last episode, the mad scientist and I threw some eggs into the extractor, hit it with CO2, pressure, and temperature, and some crazy things happened. I encourage you guys to go check out the video. Now today we're gonna be doing something a little bit different. We're gonna stick with food. We're gonna be extracting steak. What we wanna do is we wanna throw a raw piece of steak into our 5-liter pneumatic system and see if we can use that CO2, pressure, and temperature to turn it into beef jerky. Now this is a tall task and I'm gonna need some help on this. Of course, I need my mad scientist. My pleasure to introduce, as always, Director of R&D, Scott Hershberger. Scotty, where you at, buddy? Scott? Scott? Oh, come on, man, let's do some science. Now last time on Will It Extract, the mad scientist and I threw 3 different eggs into our extractor. We threw a raw egg, hard-boiled egg with the shell on, and a hard-boiled egg with the shell off. Now we got some pretty interesting results. Our raw egg, the yolk was totally extracted, and our hard-boiled eggs were impregnated with CO2. Now we're gonna stick with food, and today we're gonna be extracting steak. We're gonna be throwing this raw piece of steak into our 5-liter pneumatic system, and we're gonna try to change this into beef jerky. Isn't that right, Scott?
That's correct, Brandon.
All right, now how do we change a raw piece of meat into beef jerky in our extractor?
So essentially by using high pressure and high temperature, we're going to use the CO2 as a supercritical desiccation agent to remove the water and essentially sterilize and cook the meat. So essentially we'll have a raw and cooked piece of meat at the same time, and my hopes are that the force will actually tenderize the meat as well.
So you're telling me that CO2 is gonna beat this meat?
That's correct.
Fantastic. Let's go to the science corner and break down exactly what's going on in our extractor. Welcome to the science corner. We are running our extractor at 3,500 PSI in our solvent chamber. That pressure is equivalent to 2,500 meters underwater. Temperature is also vital in the extraction process, and we will be running at 104 degrees Fahrenheit to turn our CO2 into a supercritical fluid. The CO2 in a supercritical state will be what turns our raw steak into a dried piece of jerky. Well, hopefully, if the mad scientist's hypothesis is correct. All right, we just pulled our steak out of the extractor, and as you can see here, it doesn't look raw anymore. It does look kind of cooked. Scott, tell us what happened in the extractor.
So as we were pumping CO2 through the chamber in the steak, it appears that it pulled a combination of water, fat, and coagulated blood out of the meat.
And that's what's in this bowl, right? This came out of the isolation cup. It was pulled from the steak, right?
That is correct. And you can still see CO2 off-gassing from the liquid.
That is pretty gross. Now, for this steak, do you think it is healthy enough to eat?
Yes, I would definitely think it's very sterile at this point.
All right, well, in the name of science, we are going to eat this meat. Ooh, how is that?
It's actually pretty good, Brandon.
Yeah, nice and tender.
Mm-hmm.
How's it taste?
Actually, kind of like beef jerky.
Ah, there you have it. Fantastic. I guess it's my turn then, huh?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, in the name of science. All right, in the name of science, here we go.
So what do you think, Brandon?
Yeah, it's really not that bad. It's salty, it's dry like beef jerky is, but yeah, it's really not that bad.
Would you call it a supercritical success?
I think this is a supercritical success. This is fantastic, guys. After trying a couple pieces of this steak, it's definitely some sort of beef jerky. Now, Scott, do you think this could be a commercially viable way to make beef jerky?
Yeah, absolutely, Brandon. I feel like our pressure and temperature settings are correct. Really, what we could tweak is the time and the various levels of seasoning to make this a commercially viable product.
And this has never really been done before. Just like the egg, nobody's thrown a piece of steak into an extractor, right?
Precisely. And really, we did something in 6 hours that usually can take up to 2 weeks.
There, that's crazy. Well, that's gonna conclude this episode of Will It Extract. Thank you guys so much for watching our video, sharing, likes, we love it. For more information about IES, go to isolatesystems.com and stay tuned for another episode of Will It Extract.